The National Peace Council is asking voters in this year's elections to use the best weapon they have, voting against their political opponents rather than resorting to violence. According to the Peace Council, resorting to violence when there's disagreement is the highest form of uncivilized behavior that could lead to the loss of lives and property. Speaking after a peace march in Cape Coast, Central Region Chairman of the National Peace Council entreated all political actors to do nothing that will disturb the peace the country is enjoying. Richard Kojunyako joined the march and has more in the following report.
The peace march was put together by Play Soccer Ghana, the National Peace Council, the Coalition of Election Observers, CODEU, with support from the political parties. It was a march through the principal street of Cape Coast and consequently treated themselves to a football game on the AstroTurf of the Football for Hope Center in Cape Coast. The National Peace Council, in an address to the crowd after the march, entreated them to eschew violence and maintain the peace the country is enjoying. The Central Regional Chairman of the National Peace Council, Matthew Egan, implored on Ghanaians to use the best tool they have to vote against their opponents when they split hairs on a matter and not to resort to violence.
Let us respect different political views. When in disagreement, confront the issues, not the person. Attacking a person is violence, and violence is a weapon of the weak. Your best weapon is to vote out your political opponent in the ballot box. The consequences of a non-peaceful election are too many to recount. We don't want to lose our lives, to destroy our properties, live in fear, and be refugees, as we witnessed in some of our neighboring countries.
Country Director of Play Soccer Ghana, Franklin Esu, says the Global Peace Games that are done every year has a purpose of uniting the people and making them eschew violence when they disagree.
And the idea is to use football particularly to promote peace in our communities. We all know the key role that peace play in development. Yes, so today's program is particularly tailored towards the December polls. And the aim is to promote peace before, during, and after the 2020 elections. You know, football unites people, football brings the various teams together, and that is how we aim to promote peace.
Programs manager of Play Soccer Ghana, Antonia Santiago, urged the political actors to accept the outcome of the elections to save lives and property.
We should all learn to accept the decision, whatever the outcome of the election may be. We should learn to live in peace and in harmony. For this to be the 8th general election we've had, and we haven't encountered any issue of war in Ghana. So let us all try to maintain the peace we have.
Emmanuel Ikpe Kwaku of the CODEU appealed to the people to always remember that they are one people with a common destiny.
We teamed up together to organize this peace walk to send a message that even though we belong to different political groupings, we are still one people living in Cape Coast, we are still one people living in Central Region, and we are still one Ghanaians. So we need to conduct ourselves in a peaceful manner so that come December 7th, we will go and cast our votes and then continue to live in peace and harmony.
A football match was organized to round off the activities for the day. This year's Global Peace Games were held to bring the people together for a peaceful election. Richard Kwejenyako, Joy News, Cape Coast.